Tonight, the Target 12 investigators take you inside the mafia. We've uncovered new information in an FBI sting that took down nearly the entire family of an infamous mobster. Reputed mob captain Anthony the Saint St. Laurent, his wife and son were charged by the feds last week, accused of shaking down Massachusetts bookies for protection money. Now court documents reveal strong ties between the son and major mafia players in Rhode Island. Target 12 investigator Tim White broke the story on WPRI.com and is live now with exclusive details.
Last week, federal prosecutors tried to bar St. Laurent Jr. from associating with all felons. That didn't fly with Magistrate Judge Lincoln Almond. He wanted to know exactly who the government had a problem with. The list prosecutors submitted today is a who's who of Rhode Island wise guys. Federal prosecutors are trying to prevent meetings like this. You're looking at exclusive Target 12 undercover video of Anthony St. Laurent Jr. and outgoing mob boss Luigi Baby Shacks Minocchio chatting it up on Federal Hill. This video taken just 3 months ago. Anthony Jr. was one of three St. Laurent family members scooped up in an FBI sting last week. Also charged his father, Anthony the Saint St. Laurent, and mom, Dorothy, each charged for their role in shaking down Taunton, Massachusetts bookies for nearly two decades. With the Saint in prison, prosecutors want to keep close tabs on who St. Laurent Jr. hangs out with. Just today, prosecutors filed this motion asking St. Laurent Jr. to be placed behind bars if he associates with these reputed underworld figures. Along with Minocchio, prosecutors named former mob boss Raymond Jr. Patriaca, mafia capo regime Edward Eddie Lato, notorious mob tough guy Frank Bobo Marapisi, longtime Rhode Island mobster Alfred Chippy Shavola, Edward Buckles Malisi, who is facing federal charges of trying to move large amounts of OxyContin, and Robert Bobby DeLuca, identified by law enforcement sources as the new underboss for the Patriaca crime family. The U.S. Attorney's Office would not tell us if these men were common characters in St. Laurent Jr.'s life, but court filings refer to St. Laurent Jr. as a mob associate. Law enforcement sources say prosecutors wouldn't ask a judge for the ban if there wasn't already a history. The judge still has to rule on the government's request. For now, St. Laurent Jr. is released but on electronic monitoring. His mother is free on personal recognizance. Live with the Target 12 investigators, Tim White, Eyewitness News.
We have more inside the mafia undercover video and reaction to the federal government's filing on our website, WPRI.com.